person up, he's very brave, is Pier Giorgio Vitello. Hello. Come and tell us. And by the way, we're going to have a Q&A session after all the presentations are finished.
Hello, everyone. We all remember how were our cities during the strong lockdown. Empty, sad, but also less polluted. From this picture, we can clearly see how these effects from our movements, our daily trip, impacted on the environment of our cities. We probably don't even ever realize how strong is this impact. Only in Europe, one quarter of the total greenhouse gas emissions is given by the transport. And also transports are the main responsible for the air pollution in our cities. Only thanks to a new efficient transportation system we can fight these effects on the environment. What we need to build this new transportation system are data. Data are essential for building this new transportation system. The problem of data, for especially for transportation, is that they cost a lot. They cost a lot, but also usually the data collection period is short, and also they are limited to just specific areas. What we have right now with the advancement in communication technology is that we have right now many and many sources to collect this data. One especially of these sources is something that we always bring with us, that tracks us everywhere. That's the smartphone. Smartphones collect information about us every second, and they do it in the background, so no requirement is required from us. And sometimes some companies collect this information and provide to the community anonymized. An example is Google Popular Time. Google Popular Time is a new feature from Google that tells us how busy is a certain place, a certain store, a restaurant in a hour of the week. It gives us both the information about how busy is that place in this exact moment and also how busy is the place usually. This is a very powerful information. Just think that right now, during the Ukrainian war, Google stopped to provide this information in Ukraine in order to do not help Russia to understand where people is gathering. So what we want to do in our project is to try to explore the potential of such dataset in order to see if can give some improvements to the transportation system. In our project, we started by focusing on a specific transportation system, the metro service, and we use as case study the city of New York. We started by collecting all the Google Popular Time from each metro station in New York, and then we also collected all the information about the activities around this metro station, so all the Google Popular Time from the restaurant, the shops, just around the station. With this large amount of data, we want to understand if we are able to estimate the number of passengers exiting or entering from each station. This data would be crucial to increase the efficiency of the transportation system. So right now, our project developed an algorithm with two different outcomes. The first, where we start, so from the Google Popular Time of only the stations, and applying some machine learning technique, we arrive to the output of the live estimation of people entering or exiting from each station. While the second outcome, starting from as input only the Google Popular Time of the activities around the stations, we try to predict what will be the next future of the station. So just looking at how people is gathering in the restaurants or in the shop, we will be able to understand what will happen in the next hours in the metro station close to that activities. So this is our project, but we still have some open questions. First of all, we still want to understand which is the best area to consider the activities around the station. Right now, we are just considering a fixed radius. We also want to understand if we can, if we are able to transfer our algorithm also to other cities and to other modes of transport. For example, we are planning in the future to transfer this project also to Luxembourg and to our train station system. So, in conclusion, if we will be able to transfer this project also to Luxembourg, we'll obtain such data set that will give us a lot of information about how many passengers will be at each station in our country. This will help us to improve the efficiency of our transportation system, but as a consequence also will help us to help the environment. Thank you.